Hello, world. It's Todrick. I'm here. Just left the gym, so I'm documenting this because I don't come here very often. There's a lot of construction happening, so I hope that it's not crazy distracting. But I just wanted to address something really quickly. I have obviously been working on RuPaul's Drag Race, and it has been... Oh, my God, this is so loud. I've been working on RuPaul's Drag Race, and this last week we did this big, cool Divas number, and it was really, really, really super fun, and a lot of people really, really loved it. I got a lot of positive feedback from the episode, but unfortunately, Thorgy Thor was eliminated, and it's crazy because I was a huge fan of Thorgy. I judged her on my first episode of RuPaul's Drag Race ever, and she had a really dope green Emerald City costume on that I really enjoyed and appreciated. I love Thorgy as an artist. I had so much fun working with her. But Thorgy played Stevie Nicks, and it was a character that a lot of people didn't feel had this crazy personality that lended itself to being funny or to doing a bunch of extra choreography. And I kind of somewhat agree, which is why in the episode I said to her, listen, like, is there anything that you specifically want to do? She's not the only person I said that to. There are other people like Milk, like Aja, like BB. I said the same thing to all of them, and it shows that. But I think Thorgy is a smart girl, and I think that she understood that it wouldn't be appropriate for her to be doing crazy choreography. Not only was it not appropriate for the character, but it wasn't appropriate for the song that she was doing. Whereas Ben de la Creme did a hip-hop number as Julie Andrews, and people are tweeting me like, well, why did Ben de la Creme, why did you give her hip-hop? Because the song was obviously hip-hop. Like, the song was Call Me Mother by RuPaul, and the beat was, you know, hers was almost like a parody, and Shangela's was a parody of what she kind of did for the New Year's performance last year. And I just want to clear something up and be really crystal clear about something. I don't write the songs on Drag Race. I would love to, and then I would have a lot more to say and a lot more involvement. But I was doing Kinky Boots and practicing for Chicago and things like this and on tour with my own show when they're filming it. And so I will fly home, do the episode, fly back out to where my next show is in the middle of a crazy schedule. And so I take the tracks that are given to me. I choreograph them to the best of my ability, to what I'm given. Janet Jackson is obviously a dancer. She's known for being a dancer. You know, there are certain characters. Patti LaBelle is an over-the-top personality that would be running around the stage. I think I gave people choreography that was appropriate to the characters that they were. And I think it's really easy for people to watch an episode and decide, oh, well, this wasn't fair, or this, you know, this wasn't right, or whatever. I just want you guys to know, like, I do RuPaul's Drag Race not because I'm getting rich off of the show, but because that's like my family. I love the show. It's my favorite show. I think what it has done for the gay community and for the gay culture and for pop culture just in general, the fact that we as the LGBTQ community are finally getting the credit that we deserve for the amount of influence we have on pop culture, the way that we as a community, not myself, but the community has done hair and choreographed dances and made costumes and done makeup and redefined what it is in pop culture. Like, without these fabulous, artistically gifted gay men, there would be no Kim Kardashian, there would be no Beyonce, you know, like, there would be no Madonna, there'd be none of these people that are, like, mostly responsible for the looks and the hair and the designs and the costumes and choreography. I love everything about the show, and that's why I do it. But I was on American Idol. I have worked really, really hard to get to where I am, and I would never, ever, ever in my entire life, I know you guys, if you follow me, know this, but I would never intentionally sabotage someone or do something that would make, that could prevent somebody from reaching their goals, because A, I'm still a struggling artist. I'm still on the come up. I'm still working every day, hustling. And I would never want to prevent someone from doing something that they love to do. And I know that you don't get very many chances to do this. I know that, you know, being on American Idol and getting cut from that show was like a heartbreaking experience for me and for a lot of people that have been on the show. Some people have had to go through like major therapy and have given up on their dreams and stuff from getting cut from a show like that. And no amount of money or opportunity would be worth it for me to do something like that to someone. I love Thorgy. I think that she's a great artist. And it's really unfortunate that she's not on the show anymore, because I'm sure she had a lot of things to show. But it is a competition reality show. There are so many people that I just, like, absolutely love that have been contestants on the show. And unfortunately, they get the wrong episode. I can't think of, Ivy Winters. I think Ivy Winters is one of the most talented drag queens I've ever seen or witnessed in my life. She just recently just did this crazy stop motion claymation creation. She does stilts, she juggles, she does all of her costuming, her hair, her makeup. And I think she went home too soon. But that challenge was not the greatest challenge for her. Even though she soared in other challenges, it's sometimes the way the cookie crumbles, that you might be great on American Idol, and the one week they give you country music and you don't know any country songs is unfortunate if that's the week that you get kicked off the show. It's just how the way things are. I tossed and turned about this last night because, and I'm going to reach out to Thorgy just because I know that she knows, and I've seen her since, and I know that she doesn't think that I would purposely do anything to, like, make her not be successful, but I just was trying to think of who she could have been. Like, if she had been Pat Benatar, would it have been different? If she had been Cyndi Lauper, would it have been different? And I think that the answer is, it was really difficult. I think the producers properly cast everyone. I think everyone was given a character that they could play, you know? I don't think if Bendela Creme had been Janet Jackson, she would have done well, you know? Like, but Bendela is such a performer that she would have tried to, like, make it work for her. And I think Thorgy just felt sabotaged in what was not, like, thinking, okay, how do I spend every second of this day to try to, like, make this character do something? I have no idea what she could have done, because I don't know what, you know, like, all of the people that I feel that she is right for would have been the same. You know, Thorgy isn't a person who would be playing a Beyonce type of character or a Madonna or somebody who would be dancing a lot and do, you know, like that. I don't think that that's who she is. I don't think that is true to her aesthetic. I could be wrong. I don't want to pigeonhole anybody. And could the producers have said Thorgy should be Madonna, and would it have been different? Maybe so, but I think that they cast her properly, and she loves Stevie Nicks. And when I was trying to give her more choreography, we both agreed, like, she was like, I don't think that Stevie would do that. So she didn't have any less choreography than Aja did, even though Aja did a couple step touches, but she did step touches from the left to the right. She got picked, you know, like, Aja got picked up by two guys, but she had two drag queens backing her up. But when I was watching videos, like, doing research of Stevie Nicks to try to see if there was anything I could do that would be true to her, all I saw was a bunch of videos of her performing and spinning around. And if somebody can show me some videos of Stevie Nicks performing and doing a high kick or doing some tumbling or twerking or something that I might have missed, please tweet it to me at Todrick on Twitter, because I don't know that that exists. I looked for it. I typed in, and I know how to navigate the interwebs. Anyway, this video, for those of you who don't watch the show, is probably irrelevant, so sorry that you had to listen to this rant. But for anybody who does watch it, I just want you guys to know that. And I felt like I was, like, arguing with people on Twitter trying to prove my point. And I don't think that... I think that people are just trying to find someone to blame. And I'm so sorry that Thorgy is going through this. But I normally don't respond to things like this. But the only reason I'm responding is because I love people. And I even when Nina Bonina Brown was one of the most difficult people I'd ever worked with, I prayed about it. I came home the next day and I said, listen, I know you might not like me and you might feel defeated, but I'm going to work with your ass, because I don't want you to get sent home and regret the fact that you're in a bad mood and you think that I'm rooting for Shea Coulee over you. I don't know Shea Coulee and I don't know you. I just want everybody to do well. I talked to my boyfriend at the time about the whole situation. I was very frustrated, and part of me wanted to, in that only in that situation, be like, well, I gave her the information. If she doesn't take it, if she's not willing to work with me, if she's not willing to listen, then that's not my problem. There's nothing I can do. But I was like, you know what? I don't know what it would be like to be in this competition and feel like people are against me. I don't know, as a judge and as a mentor, we don't see what's happening in the dressing rooms and stuff. We don't get to work with them or talk to them, like, behind the scenes. So it was like, I was just like, you know what? I don't know what she's going through, but I'm gonna go in there and, like, work with her to make sure she gets this choreography and look at her in her eye and say, you might not like me. I don't think that Nina Bonino Brown doesn't like me or whatever, but I just was like, I could tell she was frustrated and going through stuff that I didn't realize until after I watched the show. But I was like, I will make this right and fight for her to do well, because it's not my job to put my personal feelings or emotions about her ignoring me and make me not want to help her. I would never do that. So anyway, I know you guys know that, but I just had to, it was on my heart to say that. I am always fair, and I think you'll, you know, see that every time I'm on the show. And I really tried my hardest to and the producers also. The producers don't sabotage anyone. I think, you know, I don't know what happens on American Idol, and I can't speak to that truly because I never worked on the show, but I felt like there was some shady stuff going on when I was on the show. But with RuPaul's Drag Race, I have watched the judges be, like, underwhelmed with someone, like a Naomi, for example, and be like, she's good, but whatever. And when Naomi came and wore that Wizard of Oz thing, everybody in the room was like, she deserves it. Like, I've never seen a group of judges so fair in my entire life. They were like, she deserved it. She did that. And, yeah, and I that's why I love being on the show, because I've never, ever, 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 ever seen anything crazy or shady or scandalous happening behind the scenes. And if anything, everybody is always like, make sure you spend an equal amount of time. I spent an equal amount of time with everybody who had big choreography, and I spent an equal amount of time with everybody whose character didn't require a ton of choreography. I will admit that I wasn't pulling Thorgy up to do a lot of the choreography because we were having to learn it so fast for the other scenes. But when she asked me if she could be in a couple more of the scenes, I absolutely was like, yeah, thank you for letting me know. I don't think Stevie Nicks really pops out to me as someone who should be dancing with a pie behind Patti LaBelle, but this is a competition, and I think that you need to be in it and be seen. And she came up, she learned it, she was great, she learned it quickly, and I made sure to, like, put her in more of the number because she brought it to my attention that she hadn't been there. I am a human. I wasn't going through being like, I need everybody to be in the same amount of numbers, because some people were not dancers and they were like, they don't get a lot of time. It's like they're performing it the next day. I would never want to sabotage someone's main part that they were going to mostly be judged on, to put them in a bunch of numbers and have them memorize things that they're not going to necessarily be judged on, you know? But yeah, last year with Sasha Peppermint and all of those girls, Sasha Peppermint, Trinity, and Shay, I really, really, like, fought for all of them because I didn't want to see any of them go. Every time I work on a finale, it's my goal to try to make it be so difficult for them to kick anyone off that four people have to go to the finale, which doesn't hardly ever happen, but they all did so well that the producers were like, they all get to go, and I think that they all deserved to go. And had they not had one of them fallen or slipped up and not done the choreography well or forgotten their parts, I think that the producers would have not let them all go, you know? I think that it was what was fair at that time. They all four were dancing to the same number, so it was like, you know, like usually when people are dancing to the same-ish song, it's easy to give them similar levels of difficulty in their choreography. But I wanted to make sure that Sasha had choreography that felt true to who she was, that Peppermint had something more campy, that Shay had something a little bit more true to the rap that she had written, and that Trinity did something that was, like, along with her brand. And I feel like I accomplished that. I feel really proud of the work that I've done on this show. And I hope to continue to work on RuPaul's Drag Race and to continue to give these girls choreography that really strongly features them and that is fair. And I think that's all I wanted to say. I love you guys so much. Make sure you're watching RuPaul's Drag Race. It's my favorite show in the entire world. I'm so lucky and flattered and fortunate to be a part of such a, like, game-changing television show, Emmy Award-winning show. That is my family. I love everyone at World of Wonder. I love RuPaul. I love Michelle. I love Carson. I love Ross. I love all the people that I've gotten to work with. And, yeah, I love you guys. Keep spreading love. Keep spreading truth. And also, it's 2018. Let's be smarter than the internet. Let's be smarter than an edit on a TV show. You have to know that a day consists of 24 hours. If you're watching something that spans across 3 days, that's 72 hours. You don't have to be a genius to figure that out. And there's no way that the producers can show every second that I spent with Milk, every second that I spent with Thorgy. They didn't even show me working with Milk at all. But, you know, but it obviously, she came up on stage and she had a number and she had choreography and she was great to work with, by the way. Milk was so professional, so sweet, and and just so on it. And I understood why she was so passionate about, you know, what happened. Maybe it was the wrong approach, or maybe they're not the right way to say it, but these people are under ridiculous amounts of stress. I want you guys to understand, living in a world where there is no phone and you're sitting there doing drag day in and day out and surrounded by cameras and stuff is a very stressful thing. So don't be too hard on these girls when they have a moment of weakness, because we have all had that. We have all done or said something at some point that if it were caught on camera, people would not like us and wouldn't understand where we're coming from. We're human. That's the beautiful thing about being a human, is that we make mistakes, we say crazy things, we get jealous, we get angry, we are ridiculous sometimes, we're PMSing whether we're a boy or a girl. That's part of life, and I think that's what makes us beautiful. If everybody was walking around being sweet and happy and kind and in a good mood and not bratty ever, then we would be not non-complex characters, and it would not like creatures, it just wouldn't be interesting. Anyway, I'm done with my rant. I love you guys. I'm going to a meeting. I look crazy with this big beard. But I hope to see you guys soon. Make sure you get your tickets to see the Forbidden Tour. I'm so excited about this music. We're about to start filming the album. And I just really can't wait to share this experience and this story with all of you. Love you. Have a blessed day. Bye.